Today we have three different technologies that I wanted to share. This is the AM/FM radio cassette player from General Electric, more than likely from the 1980s. We have the iWow 3D, fantastically immersive sound for your iPod, iPhone, and iPad. And lastly, and most importantly, the HandyCam SC5, which we'll go through in more detail than we will these two. So let's get started. The General Electric portable stereo that you see here was a great way to take your music with you on the go back in the 1980s. Perhaps you worked out or you did some jogging. This would have been an excellent companion for those outings. As you'll see, the headphones were a little bit different than what we're used to today. This was kind of the style back then, was a kind of a fat padded headphone, and ironically, this foam on this one is still intact. That's one of the tests that you'll find when you run across old headphones, especially ones with foam on them and hair. But one of the things you'll notice is that the foam has been rotted away. So underneath the foam, which is in fact replaceable, you have some little tiny speaker transducers in here, whatever you want to call them. So that's the little speakers that become your headphones, and they're actually pretty good. The sound quality is quite good for its time period. So there's the headphones themselves. Then you go over to the device itself, and again, this is a model, model number 3-5442A. It is the power of music in your pocket or on your belt, because it has a belt clip here. So you can clip it onto your belt or clip it onto the end of your jeans there. But this is a removable belt clip, so you can take it off and you don't have to look at it if you don't want to. But you can keep it on there forever if you'd like. Down here you have a place for, looks like, three AA batteries. Yes, three AAs right inside this little compartment here. So put your batteries in and off you go. On the inside here, you open the door for the cassette, which has a hook on the inside. So the cassette fits inside the door, and then you close the door like that. Now this one does not have rewind on it. It has fast forward, but no rewind. Here's your volume control here, play, fast forward, and stop. On the top, you have your tuning dial here, place for your headphones to plug in there, an indicator that you have FM stereo, and AM and tape selectors over there. And it has automatic stop, which means at the end of your tape, the machine would actually stop playing and keep your battery from running down. So this is kind of a cool thing. It's not a Sony, obviously, but there were many companies out there who attempted to copy the Sony Walkman, and this one did a pretty good job. This is a little heftier than some of these that I've run across. Even more modern, late cassette recorders are not built with as much quality as this one. It's got a metal hinge on the back for the door, for example. But very exciting way to take your cassettes along with you. Let's move on to the next item. Next, we have the SRS iWow 3D. This is a audio connection adapter, 3D sound adapter, that you connect to your iPad or iPod. Now, obviously, this particular one is the old school connection on the end. It's got this type of connector on it for this type of iPod. This is, I believe, a first generation iPod Touch we have here. But this particular unit, what does it do? Well, it interfaces between your headphones or your audio source and the iPod, iPad, or iPhone, and it has a processor, digital processor, inside this piece here that essentially expands the stereo separation of the music source that you are listening to. So here it says that you would get immersive sound for your music and movies. So if you're watching a movie or you're watching music in headphones, then it's supposed to make it better, make it more exciting, make it more interesting-like. It delivers natural and immersive sound with deep, rich bass, locates and restores audio details buried in source material, and additional color faceplates easily snap in and out for a customized look. There's a free downloadable app that lets you adjust the audio settings. Now, I was not able to get the app for this unit, so essentially it's just on or off, but I'll take it out of the package here and show it to you. I saw this on eBay, and I've always had a curiosity about SRS. You may not know this, but if you want to test drive SRS, just open up a video with Windows Media Player and right-click on the screen where the movie is playing, and you'll see some options there that you can actually go in and turn on your SRS decoding right there on your computer to experience what it's like. So this is all there is to it, to the adapter itself. So I'll hold it up a little closer here so you can see that. SRS iWOW 3D. I believe this technology was invented by CBS, if I remember correctly. I could be wrong, could be its own company. But in any case, it kind of looks like the CBS logo there next to SRS. But the little plates on the front of here are removable. So I can take this one off and say, hey, I'm going to go with rose colored today. So put that on there, and then I have changed the whole look of the thing. I'm not entirely sure how this becomes a fashion accessory, but apparently it's baked right in. So what do? You plug this onto your portable Walkman, and if the app is available, which I don't think it is anymore, you could open up the app and it would connect to the unit and customize it for you. But otherwise, it's just a toggle on and off with the white button there. Connect your headphones, or in my case, what I did is I used it in my car. So I connected it to my car's auxiliary input, audio input. And for the most part, it added a really heavy amount of bass, and I don't know, it really was a little too much for the car. It's kind of overblown a little bit, but for headphones was better experience. I will say this, that I have an old Crowded House album. I believe it's their first album, and that CD has never really sounded like much. So I ripped it to MP3, put it on the iPad or the iPod, and played it through my car, and it sounded better than it's ever sounded. So just an example of maybe an old 80s CD that you have that doesn't sound that great. You can run it through this and it will make it sound better. But if it already sounds good, then this is kind of pointless, okay? So, moving on to the next item. As you may have seen in my last video, I was looking for a way to play pre-recorded 8mm videotapes, also known as Video 8 movies, and I bought a little unit that apparently did not hold up well. It was a Video Walkman, is what it was, and needed capacitors replaced. So I took a gamble, looked around online, and what I took a gamble with was this unit right here. The guy who was selling it said, untested, does power up, and shows stuff on the screen. So I said, okay, I'll give it a try. At least it powers up, which is something the other one didn't do. And you guys know what Sony camcorders look like. The traditional, they're made long ways like this, and they have a screen that pops out on the side. Well, the thing that intrigued me about this one is how different and funky the design is. I mean, it's just really strange, but I like it. I'd never seen one like it, and I had to buy this and show it to you guys. So let's go through the Sony HandyCam SC5 as our primary feature today. So, strangely enough, it does not have a video optical viewfinder here. It has a purely optical viewfinder. And if I hold that up there, you can kind of see through there. But, I mean, it's literally a piece of glass, and you're looking through it and looking straight out to the subject that you are filming. It has some very proprietary connectors for power and for accessories, and I'll show you those momentarily. But let's just kind of go through the features. So you have an automatic focus lens, but it is not a true zoom. It has two settings. So we have Let's see, where is it? It's on the front here. So you have like a telephoto setting and a wide setting. And when you flip it, you'll see that both the lens and the optical viewfinder there both change, somewhat like old cameras from way back in the day did, before zoom lenses came along. So you just had a little flip of the lens there. Here's your start and stop. Your controls on the top here has your power, and you can do the player as well as the camera, and your off setting is in the middle. Kind of a tough button to turn. I have to kind of use my thumbnail to get that sucker to turn. If we flip it around here on the side, we have our open eject button, which allows you to load in a cassette, an 8mm cassette. Now there are three different formats of video 8mm, and this one's the first generation. So this is regular 8mm videotape. A nice hefty sized speaker there in the front, or in the back, I should say, and then an infrared port, which corresponds to this little itty bitty remote control that you see here. And it has very limited controls on it. So stop, play, pause, rewind, fast forward, and then start, stop on the recording. this screen is crazy. Look at this. So you open up the this little hood here, and it pops open, and inside there is your video screen that you can watch your video on. So if you're outdoors, you have this hood to protect the screen as well as protect light from coming in so you can see the screen much better. So that's your options as far as your filming goes, is looking here or here. We have some controls here on the bottom. So we've got our date, time, next, LCD on and off, so you can turn it on and off when you're not using it. Let's see, let's flip it over here. We've got some more controls. Oh, I'm on the right way. So we have a beep control. You have the remote commander. You can turn its control on and off. And you can change the way the start-stop button functions. So if you want it to record as you're hitting the button, so like you press record and it's recording until you let go, or you can do a start-stop, which is the traditional method where you press it once to begin, press it again to stop. Here is our information there on that little plate, CCD-SC5, and made in Japan. That's where all the good stuff is made, right? So let's see, controls for the VCR are located here. Focus, please. Thank you. And we have play, rewind, fast forward, stop, LCD brightness control, a counter reset, and a display function. We have a physical volume control here on the side, a place for a wrist strap, which I took off because it was literally rotting. Microphone is located here to record your subjects. And then here, where it gets really strange, is where the battery goes. And the battery is behind door number one. So you pull out your battery here and you can charge it. Goes in there. Close it up. So kind of a unique way to hold it. So as I'm filming it, I'm holding it like this. My hand goes around the front. Then I can reach up and do this, or I can reach up here on top and do the start and stop. The only kind of video camera I've seen that looks anything similar to this is Sharp made a line of 8 and high 8 cameras that had a screen on the front, and the lens was in like a side piece that pivoted up and down. And a lot of times when I find those, they don't work. They just probably have bad capacitors in them. So you'd probably like to see this thing powered up, and I would very much love to show you that. But first, let me show you these funky accessories that we have. Funky adapter number one is this external power supply as well as battery charger. So you could take your battery and put it here on this plate, and you could charge a battery while you were using a battery. Very helpful. I'm really glad when I purchased this camera that it included all the accessories, because I would imagine these are not very common. Many later Sony cameras use the same plugs and stuff, but look at that thing. Look kind of like a, I don't know, like a piece from a game or something, you know? Look at there. You can see the terminals there inside of it. But what is that, Tetris I'm thinking of? Yeah, it's a Tetris piece. That's what that is in there. So the Tetris plug plugs on like this, all right? And then it supplies it with, well, it's a DC output of 5.5 volts, 1.5 amp. So it's dual purpose, charges a battery here, but then at the other end of it is this really bizarre connector. And here is the bizarre connector. This connects to the bottom of the camera. So you turn the camera upside down and you slide it along this little plate. Whoops, got it backwards there. So you slide it along this little plate and it plugs in there like that. And that's how you power up the camera or supply the camera with power while you're using it if the batteries are dead, so forth. All right. Very, very strange connector type right there. It's almost like the shoe that was on some of the later Hi8 Sony cameras, and it had like an intelligent little shoe for the flash or Bluetooth audio adapters, that kind of thing. So maybe it was a predecessor to that. So the other way it gets funky is the RFU adapter. So this is the radio frequency unit. This allows you to connect the camera directly to a television utilizing channels 3 or 4, as you see there. But so here's the other end. This should look normal to you. So your television antenna would hook on here, and then this is where it would actually attach to the TV. But look at the weird way that you attach this to the camera. So again, we've got the power connector there. So we're going to hook our power adapter up there. Plugs on like that. And then to watch your movies through your television, you're going to connect this whole thing to the bottom of your Sony camera. So it snaps on. Oh, I guess I got it on backwards. Snaps on like that. Okay, see there? So now my camera is sitting on its little base, and I can just set it on the table and begin watching my movies through my television. And then to take it off of there, I have this little HandyCam release, which I press here, and the whole unit slides off. Okay, so now let's plug it in and see this sucker in action, because it's pretty cool. I've attached my funky power cord to the bottom of it, and as you can see here on the front, once I do that, the little charge light comes on. You can see that right there. But we're going to go ahead and flip open the hood on the side for the view screen, and I'll go ahead and put it in camera mode to begin with. And you'll see there, I'm 13 minutes into this video, whatever it happens to be in here. And see some additional controls there on the bottom. Here's where I can turn my LCD on or off, right there. So I can go over here on the side. Oh, I gotta put a video in there. Oh yeah, that's right. That's why that's flashing, isn't it? Okay, so, oh, by the way, here's another thing. The screen pivots. So you can lift up the screen, pivot it out, close it out like that. Kind of cool. So let's go ahead and eject. And it has the traditional Sony attachment there as far as the door where the tape goes in. I've got this pre-recorded tape. This came with many Sony cameras. It's a Sony HandyCam Handy Guide. And this is all on my channel, this entire tape. I captured it and made it a YouTube video, so be sure and check that out. But let's go ahead and put the tape in at this point. And it's beeping at me. I'm not sure why. So let's go ahead and open the panel up there. And it's saying eject the tape. How odd. Okay. Oh, because I can't record on it. That's why. All right. So let's go over here. We'll go to the player. And let's go ahead and rewind the tape. See how she does here. And apparently she's already rewound. Okay. So let's go ahead and hit play up here. And we are blue at this point. Can we fast forward? Ah, yeah, we can.
Is to the exciting world of new technology for consumers and for business. Today the topic is camcorders, and Bob, what's on tap?
You know, Joan, I just got a new camcorder with all the special features, and I made up my mind that with this new Sony, I'm going to start taking some great videos. I mean, I have all this new technology at my fingertips, and I want to take advantage of it. So, how about giving me some pointers?
Okay, well, that's exactly what we have planned for today, Bob, because you're not alone. Many camcorder owners would like to shoot better videos, but they run into one or more of these five basic problems. Moving the camera too often, holding the camera on a crooked angle, panning or zooming too quickly.
Yep, these are all problems I have constantly, but you know, I'm getting better. I keep working on it, okay? So let's do a little fast forward here. You can see what that looks like. There's the fast forward. And do some rewind or review here. See how that works. So the camera quality itself is actually pretty good. So I'm gonna make a little video here real quick and I'll show you what it looks like.
Well, here's my little video that I made on my Video 8 camcorder. And as you can see, it does not have an autofocus. It has a fixed focus lens. And I can switch over to zoom. Actually, I was in zoom, wasn't I? Okay, so here is what it looks like. And the difference between the two is zoom and not zoomed. Okay, so not zoomed and zoomed. You also notice that as I'm squeezing this camera, you can hear a lot of creaking noises as I touch the camcorder. So do be careful when you're filming that you do not do that. Squeeze the camcorder. It's very bad. All right. Well, thank you for watching, and you may now press the stop button on this camcorder.
Thought it might be fun to get a better angle at this thing so you can kind of see the inner workings of the unit. So I'm going to take the camera off the tripod here and let you kind of look at stuff inside of here. This is quite the loading mechanism here. So let's see if we can get the camera down inside of here a little bit so you can kind of see some stuff. So there it is. There's the inner workings of this amazing marvel of not so modern technology. So here is where the tape goes in at here, so we kind of get a really nice view of what's going on inside here. There's your video drum there in the center, and that is the only pickup on this particular technology, is all of the audio and video comes from that one head there in the middle. And it uses what's called AFM audio, which is audio frequency modulation. It's FM audio that is encoded onto the tape along with the video signal. And as it turns out, Hi8 brought along PCM digital stereo with this format, and some machines are actually capable of playing digital sound along with the analog picture. Don't you just love it when you're trying to make a YouTube video and the phone rings? Okay. I'm fine. I'm doing all right. All right. So as we were saying in there, the video head is controls all of the video and audio. And this is an analog device. So let's go ahead and put this Sony training tape back in just so you can see how this all loads in there. And looks like, is there instructions underneath the lid here? There is some kind of a little roadmap there. All right, so let's go ahead and turn it around this way so we can see the tape head, see the tape loading in there. There we go. All right, so tape's in. I'm gonna go ahead and clamshell the lid back together here. Come on, light. There we go. And you can see there the head is surrounded by the tape. The tape is wrapped around it in there. And you can actually see the head wrapped around that little roller right there in the center of your screen. So in order to eject, you have to close the lid and reclose it, kind of like that. Guys, thank you for joining me on this video today to explore this HandyCam SC5 camcorder. Now I can go and watch my pre-recorded 8mm tapes, like my Who Framed Roger Rabbit tape, right here on the back of this camcorder on this tiny little screen. As you can see, it doesn't stay up very well. It's not very stable. It's not very steady on its feet. But yeah, I can watch videos there, and it's got the audio and video, and audio coming from that speaker right there, and so that should be a lot of fun. Again, look this up on my channel. It's the tips and tricks for video taping, and you might actually learn something. There's actually still some good content there. Share this with a friend, and I will see you next time.